So the school improvement model in Michigan is based on four steps: gather, study, plan, and do. And the data dialogue process is a perfect alignment because it allows you to gather the data to determine what your subject will be for the data conversation, and then to analyze that data so that you can plan effectively. There are many different ways of looking at data and engaging people in conversations, and a data dialogue is nothing more than a very structured conversation that's intended to engage everyone at the table around a very detailed analysis of the data that's being presented. The whole purpose of MyExcel is to bring about rapid improvement in district systems and in thinking so that you can bring about rapid improvement in student achievement. So the data dialogue process really helps to unearth and identify some of those causes which can be confirmed with data so that we can plan thoughtful interventions, research-based interventions, to bring about that rapid improvement in student achievement. Participants in these data conversations should be key leaders, people who have the ability and the authority to make key decisions, but they also need to include teachers. You know, we know that all of the changes that really are going to matter are done at the classroom level. So you really need to have a mix, a blend of district administrators, building administrators, and classroom teachers and teacher leaders within a particular school. Preparation for the data dialogue process can be done a couple of different ways. Currently, Michigan State University specialists are in the field for priority and focus schools to help build capacity for these data dialogue conversations. And so the first conversation might be completely planned by the MSU specialist. But if an administrator or someone in the district or school were going to plan a data dialogue conversation, the first step is to really figure out what it is you want to explore. What issues are presented that you want to have a deep conversation about? And then that will help you determine which kind of data that you want to bring to the table. So we advocate the use of multiple measures of data, and most schools and districts begin with student achievement data because that data has determined whether a school has been identified as a priority or focus school. But we also encourage them to triangulate that data and to look at other measures of data, process data, perception data, and demographic data as well.